IHMA. I welcome you all on behalf of IHMA Kerala State Chapter. Dear delegates, this is the last session of Season 2 webinars. And from IHMA Kerala State Chapter, we have conducted around 50 sessions in Season 1. And this is Season 2. And today is the last part of Season 2. So, dear delegates, only the permitted recording will be uploaded. And before starting the session, never forget to salute our master, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann. We feel very grateful for him as a homeopath. We should all our credit to him. So thank you so much, master. And today as a speaker, we have Dr. Subhas Singh. And before introducing the speaker, I would like to invite Dr. Deepu to give few words regarding IHMA. Dr. Deepu?
Yes, I'm here. So, good evening all. I myself, Dr. Deepu. You might be knowing me since this webinar has started. So, today we are going to end our journey here in this session. It was a very fascinating journey. Lots of stalwarts came to our platform. And it was a nice experience to learn more from this lockdown period. I have special mention for Dr. Subhas sir, even though my friends are studying there, I haven't asked them for getting me for to get sir in our program. Sir, actually Dr. Prashant is a good friend of mine. Dr. Prashant Shashitharan is a very good friend of mine.
Okay.
He's working in IHMA since I have came through. And Dr. Ashwini is there, Dr. Fatima, all are my friends.
Yes.
So it was a nice experience, sir. And also to all my people, all the doctors who joined us, we are very thankful for them. And it's a great session. Thanks for supporting us wholeheartedly. Hope you will be there as an inspiration to us. Hope you learned from it and enjoyed participating. So nothing to say more. We will come up with some good programs in future. And today, as a speaker, we have Dr. Subhas Singh sir from NIH. And you should let me tell you, my doctors. Actually, I have a little bit knowledge about this NIH. But when these people studied there, I only came to know that NIH is that such a big platform, big hospital. And if anybody feels that homeopathy is not worth learning, you should just go to NIH and you can see how much OPD they have. And so this Subhas sir is a great faculty, and I have seen some of his ortho webinars, and he had no date for us actually, but he called me and he just given me this date on this special day. So thank you so much, sir, for supporting us. And on behalf of IHMA, I really express my gratitude to you. So
thank you
all for making this thing very beautiful. And hope you will support us in upcoming seasons. So thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Deepu, for your kind words. And you are such an inspiration for all. No doubt. And today, I would like to introduce today's faculty, Dr. Singh sir. From North Zone, the most talented and senior faculty we have. I'm also from North Side. So welcome you, sir. And I have seen your many seminars and I have attended also. And I'm a student of GD Memorial. So I would like to introduce Dr. Subhas Singh. He's a BHMS MD and a PhD scholar. He is reader and associated professor, HOD, from Organon of Medicines from NIH, National Institute of Homeopathy, Kolkata. Dr. Singh working in NIH since 1997, and he's a BHMS from Calcutta, Homeopathy Medical College and Hospital, MD from SK Homeopathy Medical College and Hospital, Maharashtra, and PhD from Maharashtra University of Healthcare Science, Nasik, Maharashtra. Dr. Singh authored many books. Among them, some of Mind, a Simplified Study, Doctor-Patient Relationship, Samuel Hahnemann's Organon of Medicine, a Study in Its History and Evolution, Textbook on Introduction of Study of Homeopathy Metria Medica, and Textbook of Homeopathy Metria Medica Part 1, and many more. published many research papers, scientific papers, around 130 approx, and delivered many lectures in CME, ROTP, and seminar, conferences, workshop, and many more. Dr. Singh decorated with many prestigious awards like Order of Merit in 1994 by University of Calcutta. So thank you so much, sir. And he's guider of around 50 scholars of MD, including my college also, and examined almost all of the board examinations, BHMS, MD, PhD as well. He's the main body over research committee membership and a member of ethical committee of NIH, member of research advisory committee NIH. So it's great privilege to have you here, sir. From IHMA Kerala State Chapter, I show my sincere gratitude and welcome, sir. Please start the session. Thank you so much. And the event is sponsored by Advent Biotech. Go with the nature. So, dear delegates, we have legend today. So let's welcome him. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. I didn't get your name.
Doctor, myself, Anupriya.
Anupriya.
Yes, doctor.
Thank you very much, Dr. Anupriya. And
sir, I'm your student as well. In Patna, I have attended many seminars and I'm very familiar with you. But okay. So big faculty, you don't notice me. But you're so
I must have noticed. Actually, I can't see your face.
Of course, doctor.
No problem. So, thank you very much. Thank you especially to the young doctor who has contacted me and been in touch regularly and given me this opportunity to be with the doctors of IHMA. It is all because of Dr. Deepu that we have gathered here. I myself came here. Since you were talking about NIH, so let me start with a bit of NIH. I am at presently working as the director of National Institute of Homeopathy, Kolkata. And as we know, those of you who have not visited, I will request you to come at least once to NIH. I can't say much about it, but especially I will say ki we are very proud of the faculty that we have here. We are very proud of our students, the past especially who are doing so good, and the present. And we have a very good OPD, 2000 plus per day, and a 100-bedded hospital. And we are also involved in various research works. So whenever you get time and if ever you visit Calcutta, please do come and make sure to visit NIH once. Now coming to the topic that is the slide visible?
Yes, doctor, it's very clear, but you should put it in a full screen.
Okay.
It's okay now. You can start.
Yeah. In the sidebar, the names are coming. How can I remove it? Okay. No, it's done.
Sir, I will do. No problem.
So actually, when Dr. Deepu asked me to present a lecture on this platform, at that very time, I was having some problem in the place where I'm staying. I stay in an apartment and we have a group of buildings there. And those are all very familiar with each other. And one of them at that time, in one of the building at that time, one of the person has tested positive for Corona. And as you can understand, the situation nowadays when you are in an apartment and a complex, that creates a havoc. So everybody was so tensed up that what will happen now? And there was, including me, I was also very much apprehensive. I have a mother who is diabetic and there is another lady, our full-time maid, who is also diabetic. So in spite of myself being doctors, and there were so many other doctors also who were in the complex, but we were all becoming very apprehensive, very worried and tensed up. So that gave me an idea that I would like to use this opportunity to discuss some of the rubrics that comes in mind whenever we think of COVID. I'm not talking about the common symptoms of COVID. I'm not talking about what we get as a complication of But I'm specially talking about the mindset of the persons who are living during this COVID time, not those who are affected by COVID. So how it affects us on a mental plane, and what are the changes that happens? That is what has given rise to this search for a rubric in COVID time, this topic. Any major epidemic outbreak has negative effect on individual and society as a whole. Now we are practically we are witness to this, that when this COVID is happening, the effect, the negative effect that it has on each individual, the family, the society is enormous. Pandemic are frequently marked by uncertainty, confusion, sense of urgency, and major epidemic outbreak has negative effect on individual and society as a whole. As you must be seeing in the newspaper and in the television, that people are reacting in different way. Sometimes they react, they are totally banishing the family who is affected, ostracizing the family who is affected, and sometimes out of the way people are going to help them also. So there is uncertainty how people will react, and this is irrespective of what is your educational background, what is your profession. Even those of us who are doctors or who are highly qualified, their reaction also sometimes is very peculiar. So other psychological stressors include health threat to oneself and the loved ones. There may be severe disruptions of routine, separation from family and friends, shortage of food, medicine, weight loss, social isolation due to quarantine and other social distancing programs, and school closure. The school closure reminds me of the children. Those who are in the house. See, all of us may not have big house. Many of us are living in apartments and very small apartments. And being enclosed in four walls for such a long duration, at a tender age when you are playing and physically active and mentally very active, going to school and coming back, and just think of those kids. What is happening to them? So these are the problems one has to think of. Lack of social and physical contact with others. Nobody, even neighbors are not talking to each other. Everybody is very much afraid. Post-traumatic stress disorder via wearing masks. We have to wear masks always. And I have seen people wearing two or three masks, even when they are gasping. But just to be as careful as possible, they are using these masks of different layers. Low self-esteem, mood disorder, fear, guilt, loneliness, boredom, all these things are happening to everybody who is affected. Feeling of lack of control, insomnia. Many a time I have seen and I have heard people that when they get up in the night once for because of any reason, then it is very difficult for them to go back to sleep. Perceived dirtiness, vigilant hand washing. You may have seen people who are developing fungal infection because of so much of washing and repeated washing, and they are getting all type of problems, skin problems of the hands. Avoiding crowd and social gathering even after quarantine or isolation. So these are some of the factors which are mental states which have affected people at large in corona times. And then these are some of the rubrics that had come in my mind. And most of these are from Kent repertoire. I'm just sharing it with you. The first one is mind, want of self-confidence. That is because the first reaction, if you remember, when the corona started, the first reaction during the first few days was, it won't happen to me. It will not affect me. And that is why people were so careless. And when the numbers started increasing, then they found that the total self-esteem, the confidence, that is gone. So this is the first thing. And then added factors are problems in the job. There is huge number of job loss, problems in the getting the ration and everything. So as a whole, those who were totally in control of their life, now they are having this want of self-confidence. And whenever we think of self-confidence, then the medicine that comes in mind is Aurum Baraita. I'm talking only of first grade and second grade. Aurum Baraita, Bryania, China, Kelicard, Lacaninum, Lyco, Pulsatilla, Silesia. We all know that if you read Kent, then you will find that he has wonderfully described Lycopodium and Silesia as far as lack of self-confidence is concerned. I have been fortunate enough to be a student of Dr. Dubey, Dr. S.K. Dubey. And he used to say that Lycopodium is a person who is, suppose, for example, he used to give this example, that the person is born in a lawyer family. His father, his uncle, all are lawyers. And then he has studied up law. And then he has been a topper. And then when the time comes for the first appearance in court, then he is going to a place where he knows everybody. The judge is a friend of his father. The most of the people who are his opponent, he is also known to the family. So everybody is known. He has prepared his task so well. In spite of that, when he's going, then he is feeling total lack of confidence. I may not be able to do it. And then when he starts, after initial 5 minutes of hesitation, then he is outdoing everybody, outshining everybody, because he's very intelligent. So initial lack of confidence in Silesia and Lycopodium. Both of them are very intelligent. Both of them are performing very easily. And other medicine you have done. I have intentionally not talked of Anacardium, because Anacardium, this want of self-confidence, is very pathological. This lack of self-confidence is giving rise to very much aggressiveness in case of anacardium. And it is sometimes so severe that it may not be brought back to the normal state. Confusion of mind. In corona, there were different times, there were different information shared. And thanks to WhatsApp and Facebook and newspaper and television, we are really confused. At one point of time, we heard that it is not spreading by air. Then we heard that it is spreading by air and it is going to remain in air for 7 to 8 hours. Whether washing of hand is enough or washing of hand is not enough. I have seen people going to market, taking the currency notes, and then washing it, washing the vegetables. I don't know how far good it is for health or how far good ultimately it is, but there is a complete confusion of mind. So this is a huge rubric. I'm not going in detail about this, but this is a state which is very common in corona times. Another rubric that comes in mind. See, corona, luckily, in Indian setup, and thanks to the familial setup, the way the family lives, the way we are living, the number of death is very less in comparison to other countries. And one reason is, I believe, that mortality is more usually in aged person. And in Indian society, we take very good care of our senior citizens. Whether he is a father or mother or grandfather, grandmother, usually they are not allowed to go without any help. They are not allowed to go to market. They are very much taken care of. And that is giving rise to these people not being affected. In spite of that, there is a feeling that if it happens, whether it is curable or not, if I die. So this delusion that disease is incurable, I have a disease which is incurable, that is also a state of mind in these times. And the medicine we can see is Argentum and Sabadilla, besides Cactus, Chelidonium, and Plumbum. those who are affected or those who are not affected. Both. The problem is, I don't know, the way the number are increasing, the problem now is that it is really doubtful if any one of us are safe. The question is that if we are affected, then then whether I will recover from it or not. Because there are so many complications, known and unknown, which happens. So the medicine, the first medicine that comes in mind is aconite, because of its fear, because of its suddenness. This is the medicine that has to come in mind. And then acid force. We all know acid force as a medicine for, you know, weakness and prostration and so many complications arising out of failure in love and all that. But there is another factor, that is fear in acid form. Fear as well as fright. The problems arising out of it, or the sequelae of fear, bad effects. So this doubtful recovery of is nothing else but a sense of fear. And the medicine we have is aconite, again, for suddenness, and acid force for this fear and fright arising out of it. Yeah. Some of the symptoms of aconite that came in mind, I put it here. Great fear and anxiety of mind, afraid to go out into a crowd, to cross the street. These are from Allen, basically. The countenance is expressive of fear. Countenance means the face. Life is that fear is such an important factor in case of aconite that the whole life becomes, not only of the patient, but his relatives and family members, it becomes something very much disturbed because of this fear thing. And timidity, especially after a fright. Now this corona has given rise to another fear. We all know that initially, as a human being, Homo sapiens, we were living in jungles, individually. And then, very slowly, the concept of society, living together, came. And then came family and society and villages and towns and nations. Because man is basically a social animal. And this corona has again brought us to the basic where we don't want to talk to anybody, where we are afraid of meeting people, where we are afraid of mixing with the people. And here is the rubric which Kent has given us, that fear approaching of others. Arnica, we all know that there is a pain or something, and that is giving rise to that if anybody approaches, I will have, he will touch my painful area. The painful area is so sensitive, but this sensitiveness is also in the mind, mental level. And that is why the person is afraid that if I mix with anybody, then this will give rise to sensitive fear of approaching others. And that is the reason why Arnica avoids people. That is the reason Arnica has a fear of mixing with others. That is the reason why Arnica has a problem if anybody approaches it. So in second grade, we have Ambra grigia, Belladonna, Cuprum, Ignatia, Lycopodium, Stramonium, and Thuja. When you don't go to office or college or school, how much of television you can watch? How much of newspaper or books you can watch? And ultimately, people are staying home to themselves and are brooding, thinking about what will happen, diseases, illness, society, their past life. So these things come in mind and is ultimately crowding the thoughts. So brooding is another rubric that comes in mind, and the medicine in first grade that we have, Ignatia. Especially, we all know Ignatia as a very, very hypochondriac person, an oversensitive person. A nuts vomica, female nuts vomica, except there are some basic differences. It may not be so short-tempered, it may not be so chilly, But other things are there. And then we have Veratrum. In second grade, we have Gelsemium, NASA, and again acid falls. Mental sadness and depression, it's a huge rubric. There are so many medicines. And all of these medicines have this symptom, the sadness or the mental depression, which is so prevalent during times. Almost all of us have some component of depression happening. And this depression may give rise to, it may not always be expressive. It may not be always be very recognizable. The depression can be very subtle. And this depression can be such that it can go to the pathological level and people may commit suicide. Because the uncertainty, the fear, all these are complicating this depression. And usually when you mix with people, you go out in society, go out in the family, then you have way of sharing your views. You are ventilating. But in this corona time, you don't get an opportunity to mix with people. You don't ventilate your thoughts. And this is further aggravating the factors. So mental sadness, mental depression, this is another rubric to be thought of. Ignatia, we all know, medicine of great contradiction. If we start describing Ignatia and the way the depression is affecting Ignatia, just one thing I would like to say, that Ignatia finds out the reason to be depressed of. Anything, it can be anything. It can be anything which a normal people enjoys. That makes the Ignatia very sad. Because there is a contradiction, because there is a hypochondriasis, oversensitiveness, hysterical mentality. So these things has to be thought of in Ignatia. And Veratrum, we all know that delusion of impending misfortune. Fear, bad will happen. Not really, but delusional level. And that causes serious depression. Violent mania, alternative silence and refusal to talk. She is inconsolable over a fancied misfortune. And this sometimes alternates with very violent type of mania. As we know, Veratrum album has all the three type of brooding, melancholia, violence, and religious. All these three phases are there in Veratrum album. There is another rubric in Kent, cautiousness. Those of us who are washing the notes, that currency notes that they get from market, or are wearing 3-4 masks, or are, you know, washing the vegetables. I am not saying these are bad things. Being cautious is good. But when it is, because all these rubrics are not, because they are not normal. That is why these are rubrics. They are symptoms because they are not normal. So when a person is normally cautious, we don't think of a rubric or a medicine. But when this cautiousness extends to abnormalcy, then we have to think of medicine like causticum, graphitis, epica, and magnetis poli articus. Yeah, so causticum, you see, mind is sad, somewhat anxious, anxiously careful as to all occurrences, great apprehension as to what will happen. This uncertainty is giving rise to this carefulness, this cautiousness. Single medicine, arnica. The reason is different. But here we can think of arnica because in corona time, this has become one of the very prominent symptoms. Nobody is touching anybody. It should not happen. But when it is beyond normal, then we can think of arnica. In synthesis repertoire, there is a rubric. He fears contagion. See, where there is a chance of getting affected and you are being careful, you are afraid, then we are not talking of these rubrics. When there is no chance, then we are talking of these rubrics like arsenic, like carcinogen. Arsenic, I'm not talking about, I would like to talk about carcinogen. Again, a medicine of contradiction as far as desires and aversion are concerned, as far as modalities are concerned. See, by one symptom or one rubric, you cannot prescribe or you cannot identify. Identification has to be done by generalities. Individualization has to be done by generalities. So these rubrics help us in thinking of that medicine. When I see a person who is very much afraid of being affected by a contagion, and this is giving rise to always cleaning hands, washing hands overtly, too much, almost miss OCD stage, then we think of carcinosis. Then we think of syphilinum. Then, you know, see, there's another medicine, sulfur. That is also there when there is a fear of contagion. Very interestingly, I'll just say, because I don't have enough, I have to cover other things also. Like washing mania and carcinosin and syphilinum, we all know, it is also in sulfur. Though sulfur has an aversion to be washed, sulfur has an aversion to take bath. But in spite of that, there is this symptom is wonderfully described if we get in sulfur also. Again, in synthesis, we get another medicine, fear. There another symptom, disease of impending contagious, epidemic disease of. And the medicine, sulfur and syphilinum. First grade is calcarea. Calcarea is always fear, fear and fear. Everything the calcarea patient is afraid of. Calcarea also has a very prominent medicine for lack of confidence. So calcarea in first grade and sulfur and syphilinum in second grade. Fear of death. One of the things that affecting our mind during corona time is this fear. Fear of death. We all are usually afraid. Nobody wants to die. But when this is pathological, there are people who are cooped up in their home, not coming out once. And why? Because they will get affected. And why? What is the fear? Fear is death. Then we can think of this group of medicine. Fear death of respiratory complaints. There are so many ways that people can die, but in corona times, you know, the respiratory complaint has become most prominent. The effect, the way it has affected, it has become most prominent. And two medicines, arsenic and lobelia, cover this fear. The way our whole health system is, especially the government hospital, and see, good news is never given in television or newspaper. If anything bad happens, that is always given. There are so many persons who are getting admitted to hospitals. They are cured and they are well treated. You will never find these in news. But once or two, if something bad happens or maltreatment is there or bad behavior is there, then that is always there and that is affect us. So we have an image that if I go to hospital, then I'm surely going to die. Most of us cannot afford going to private hospital, and government hospital, the way it is depicted, is something where you won't come back. So fear hospital going to Argentum and Calcarea. Fear of infection, Borax, Bufo, Caladium, Calcarea, and Lacus. Fear of being neglected in synthesis. If I get admitted, or the way in the beginning, as I was saying, that once somebody get affected, then the problem is that nobody comes, nobody shares, nobody talks. You are totally removed from the society. As if you have done a sin. So fear of being neglected. Sorainam and Pulsatilla. Another very similar rubric is forsaken. Neglected is intentional. Forsaken means when you are left alone. That forsaken feeling, especially during this corona times, is very prominent. And aurum metallicum, syphilitic medicine. Sorainum, soric medicine. pulsatilla, a psychotic medicine. All these three have this particular symptom. Other than that, argentum, cyclamine, lachesis, platina, and stramonium. Sleeplessness. But reason, anxiety. Arsenic and cocculus. And in second grade, we get caustic. From fear, if I can't sleep because of fear, then we have aconite, bryonia, cocculus. Just a moment. আপনি জোশ কে বলুন যে একবার ফোন করবে একে সুভাষ চৌধুরী আছে কি চলে গেছে যদি থাকে তাহলে আপনি সো সর সো একোনাইট ইন ফার্স্ট গ্রেড ওয়েন দ্য ফিয়ার এন্ড দেন ইন সেকেন্ড গ্রেড উই হ্যাভ ব্রাইনিয়া ককুলাস পালসেটিলা রাস্টক্স এন্ড ভেরেট্রাম ফিলিং অফ হেল্পলেসনেস ইউ হ্যাভ মানি You have resources, you are taking all the possible care, then also we are helpless. Because you do not control the disease. Nothing is in our control. We do not know who is affected. See, the names, the big names that we see who are affected and the advanced age in which they are, I'm sure they must have taken every possible care. In spite of that, when they are affected, So you don't know what to do. And then you are helpless. And the medicine is helleborus, calibrum, petroleum, phosphorus, tramonium, and tacticum. Mind, mood changeable. One of the things that is affected when the people are living in family and in home for such long period, not going out, that all of us are becoming hysterical. And this mood changeable, short temper, being angry on trifles. These are the symptoms that we find. And we have wonderful group of medicine for mood changeable. Pathetic. Two medicine in synthesis, sepia and stramonium. And pessimist, again, not in Kent, but in synthesis. You can't think of anything good. The darkness, the pessimism is overpowering. And the medicine we see, if we know this medicine, then you can, visualize. The fun of studying repertory is if you know your materia medica. Because when we say alumina, then if you know your materia medica, then you can, in mind, it should flash the pessimism of alumina. Who is alumina? A chilly person. A shrunk, dried, lean, thin, chilly person. Psoric person. Who is always brooding. Who is always thinking of the bad things. Who do not see happiness. And this is the medicine. Like, there is another medicine, lacanainam. And there is a symptom, chronic blue condition. In Allen, you will find that there is a symptom written, chronic blue condition. Now, blue mood is dark mood, negative mood. And chronic means long affected. I don't know why it is not added. But the alumina, simisifuga, these can only be enjoyed if you know the symptoms. Then when you hear the word pessimism, then these things flashes in your mind. Till that level is not reached, especially to my young friends, I will suggest that when you read this, then go to your materia medica and see how in simisifuga you get the pessimist symptom. Because you may know, all of us, know the characteristic of simisifuga, but I want this symptom to be come in my mind. And this is how we use repertory to enrich our knowledge of materia medica. from grief, prostration of mind, ignitia, lecithin, and acid force. There is another rubric, suicidal disposition. Now, corona may not be responsible for suicidal disposition, because this is a disposition. But corona may be responsible for bringing this disposition to the forefront. It may be somewhere lying down, it may be somewhere in the background, and during this trying time, testing time, it has come in the forefront. So suicidal disposition, and all the good medicines are here, aurum neur, aurum metallicum, natron sulf, and a huge number of medicines. Again from synthesis, thought, disease of incurable. The person is constantly thinking that this disease is incurable. See, I have known people, and you may be also knowing people, that they have sneezed once or twice, or had a cough, or just feeling of malaise, and they started smelling things that my smell is okay or not, because loss of smell is a symptom of corona. Or tasting that, okay, my taste is normal or not, because loss of taste. And then having a oximeter in home, testing your pulse, testing your oxygen level, and testing your blood pressure. So these are the reactions that happen, and all these rubrics are to analyze and to study these reactions. And one of these, the thoughts, disease of incurable, arsenic and mercury. Fear of impending disease. I'm not suffering now, but I will suffer from a disease. Calicarb and phosphorus in first grade. Calicarb cannot bear to be touched, starts when touched, ever so lightly, especially on the feet. Because see, this is a rubric. Out of all the rubrics that we have studied, this is a rubric which is common to all of us. All of us are afraid that today I may not be positive, but tomorrow I don't know. So we all have this fear of this impending disease. But we can't take medicine from this group, because that is only natural to be afraid. But when this fear becomes to such an aggravated stage that it has to be considered as a pathological symptom, it has to be considered as a symptom of disease, then this rubric has to be applied. And Calicarb is the first group medicine. We all know Calicarb, or antipsoriatic medicine. A medicine who has fear in a very prominent stage. Lack of confidence. Severe fear. Fear to be touched. Starts when touched. Ever so lightly. Aggravation from touch. Fear of, full of fear and imagination. Great aversion to being alone. Cannot express herself. Seems at a loss to know how to begin or say. Timid, apprehensive of future, about her disease, fear of being alone, fear she will die. So all these things, so you can understand how pathetic this Calicarb person is and how afraid and fearful this person is. Similarly, the medicine is phosphorus. Though a very intelligent person, but when this fear comes of the disease, the person's life is becoming totally wretched. Nervous, weak, desire to be magnetized, oversensitiveness of all senses to external impression. Death, dread of death when alone. When alone, the broodingness, the thought, that is causing problem. And mind is overactive. Great flow of thoughts, difficult to arrange. The thoughts, anxious, filled with gloomy foreboding, as if about termination, fear and dread in evening and death, dejection. Thought, he will die. These are the symptoms of acid force. Similarly, we have lacanine, a very depressive person. But interestingly, the person is so depressive, this chronic blue condition, as I said, there's another symptom in lacanine, cannot find a friend worth living for. Lacanine, in her life, there is nobody for whom the lacanine patient thinks I should live for. But lacanine, all these things do not give rise to suicidal tendency. We have to keep in mind. depressed, sadness, melancholia, weepiness, but not suicidal. So anxious, fear of disease, of consumption, of heart disease, sits and looks under chair, table, sofa, or depression of spirit, doubts her ability and success, thinks she will hurt, all these things are there. And that gives rise to a very depressed person. Lack of life. As it falls, as I have said, he's sad, especially about the future, sad and feeling of solicitude, as if you'd be sick, sad, earnest, discouraged, he's constantly complaining about his illness, he looks very ill-humored and morose, the look-wise also, as it falls. So that everyone asks him what is the matter, although he is not sick. On the other hand, we have Arnika, where the person is gravely sick. And if somebody asks him, what is your problem? He says nothing. Though he is sick. Anxiety and doubt concerning his recovery. Dread of future, brooding over one's condition. These are some of the... I know that this is not a complete list and we can go on adding and adding and adding. But let this be a beginning for all of us. Those who want to study in this way. Let this be a beginning so that we can study further. And you can go on adding rubric. So this was my, just what I wanted to share with you. And I don't know whether the time will permit for questions.
Thank you.
But Doctor, just a moment. Before I conclude, I must thank IHMA for giving me this opportunity. And I also take this opportunity to pray that all of you be safe and healthy in coming time. Take care of yourself and your family. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. It was such a wonderful session. And it was, you know, as we have many legends experience regarding COVID-19. But today it was so beautifully concluded by you. No doubt it was such a yielding presentation, sir. And I hope it's very will be very beneficial for all. So thank you so much, sir. It's our privilege to have you here. And from all IHMA family, I show my sincere gratitude. And sir, we want your more further sessions.
Sure. I'm always there here. Dipu, I'm always here.
Most welcome, sir.
Yeah, sir.
Sure. Anytime. Just let me know when your next thing starts. We can always join.
Yeah, we will definitely contact you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
See, I was waiting for someone actually. He's not joined actually. Our national secretary was about to come. It's okay, sir. No problem. So,
give him my good wishes. And please permit me to leave. I'm still in college only, you know. I have to go home.
Yeah, I know. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much. Take care, all of you.
Okay. Dr. Deepu?
Yes.
Actually, I think we have some 1 or 2 minutes time for our participants.
Okay. I will make them on. Okay, 1 minute.
Okay.
You can ask them to share experience. I think Dr. Anjali Sharma. Dr. Anjali, you can unmute yourself and you can give the feedbacks.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Hello.
Teacher.
Thank you so much, Deepu sir and Anupriya ma'am. It was a great job. Actually, it was very useful for us because in COVID-19, we thought like everything will be get just stopped. Like there is no way, just home. Then, but thank you to all the team of IHMA. It was a great job. We enjoyed it a lot, and we are waiting for further sessions too, sir and ma'am. We request you to bring that session soon so that we can do it this session, like this enjoyment of studies and all with all our legends and with you all too. Thank you. And I was waiting for the moment to come back to your feedback dungi because you guys are best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, doctor. You're such a nice girl. And thank you so much for your nice words. And keep watching. You know, you all are the part of IHMA family. From these must days, I feel like a family with all you. Very family apart you all are. So most welcome. We can
ma'am, we feel the same. We feel the same.
Dr. Deepu, you just allow one or two more participants.
Those who wanted to talk anything, please raise your hand. I will make them unmute. No problem.
If any senior doctor wants to share their experience,
hello,
they are most welcome.
Hello, good evening, ma'am. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Good evening, doctor.
Yeah, it was so much great. I learned a lot of from Dr. Deepu and many other senior doctor. I am very, very thankful for such a great session, and I would like to join again. I am from Punjab. Hello?
Yes, doctor, we are hearing you.
Yeah, actually, I learn a lot from many of the senior doctors and who had assisted me and guided me in every aspect. And especially, I was curing an autistic child and he's improving so much. So thank you so much for such a great learning. And I would like to join more session, please.
Most welcome, doctor. And we are here to provide you everything. We don't want any compliments. Okay, you just give me your advice also. What we have to improve, you know, what we have to do more, or where we are failing actually. So you can give your all type of feedback. You know, we are not any from other planet. Anybody will come to teach us. You know, we are the people. We have to help each others. Okay. So you can give your all type of experience, what we have to do more, what we have to improve, all these type of comments. Okay.
Is there anyone to share any thoughts? We can raise your hand. Okay. And also, I'm not like to ask for the membership in this list. So for that, we have a good national committee there, and they're coming in with some webinars too, and we will provide the details updates in the Hope Telegram as well as the WhatsApp groups. So if you have any suggestions, you can just tell now. You can raise your hands, we will hear you. Actually, we have 10 or 15 minutes. Those who conduct you, those who just click on the IHMA Kerala official, you can easily subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yeah, for very much.
Okay, Vijay Rohra, Vijay. Okay, Vijay, Dr. Vijay, you can unmute yourself.
Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, doctor. Hello? We can hear you.
Sir, first of all, I would like to thank you and your whole group for allowing us to attend your seminars and learn so much from you people, because nowadays the scene in homeopathy is like every specialized homeopath is like trying to improve his own knowledge, sharing only the limited part, and as he doesn't want any competition, he is not sharing the whole knowledge with other students. But you people have selflessly done this, and I really want to thank you for that. I also want to ask, like, after the webinars are over, is there any chance to be a permanent member of your group so that I can learn from you?
We have our life membership there for the 15 years, and we also have the temporary membership. Actually, I have sent the details in some webinars.
Okay.
You can, those who wanted to be a part of IHMA can just message me in my number. I will type in the chat box. 8-9-2-1-9-6.
Okay.
You can be a part of IHMA. Whether you are, we have even have our international chapters in Europe as well as Dubai, and many more chapters are coming up. So there is no point in that. Anytime you can join us.
Main reason is your selfless approach to homeopathy and the way you people want others to learn from your efforts. Thank you so much for that. Thank you, sir.
Welcome, doctor.
Yeah, some suggestions came up like bird remedies. So regarding the YouTube update, I have to mention some few things. See, we don't have any problem in sharing all these things with you. We are not going to sell this because these people are voluntarily given the webinars. It is with their permission only we can put the videos in the YouTube. So whatever videos are not coming in YouTube has been restricted by the doctor himself. So we can't do that anything. We should respect their privacy. So we can't do anything like that.
Actually, doctor, it's not upon the doctors, okay? We have to preserve the patient's privacy too. So being a doctor, we have to follow some protocols also. So this is not the problem with the speaker. This is the problem with the privacy. We have to keep privacy of our patients. So this is the main reason. So any more senior doctors wants to share their experience?
Dr. Anupriya, I think we can wind up. People can message me personally in the WhatsApp group as well as in the...
And I have already invited everyone in the group that we have already three groups of WhatsApp and that Telegram group. So thank you so much, participants, for being with us such a longer time. And I must mention, you all become a part of IHMA family. It's a very, I think... heartbroken period for me especially. I'm so younger actually. So we are not going to be tomorrow by that 2:30 or 8 p.m. But it doesn't mean you will stop learning, okay? You have to be there for studying purpose or for your any important work. So doctors, we are always with you as it's a motive of hope that helping one another for their professional benefits. So keep watching, keep learning, and stay tuned with us in the third session. We will meet you
Actually, in the WhatsApp, we haven't made it open because there will be storming of messages. So you can message the admin, okay? In a group, you can message. If you have any personal suggestions regarding our future, you can also message me in personal, in a whoever, maybe in your group, this handle. And also, I just provide you a hope feedback group. In that feedback group, you also can join. In that, we used to discuss with the people. Actually, we have done like that in last 2 weeks. We have received so many suggestions. Even with the bed remedies, actually, I have done one session, but the time was not allowing to continue that. Actually, it was Dr. Priya Subramaniam. She was about to take the bed remedies, actually. So we will come up, but we are taking a short break now. There will be webinars in locally, and you will be notified in this. And I have no privilege to tell this, but I will tell you that please update that the Illuminary is coming. It will be launching by this 28th. I hope. So there is no official confirmation so far came up. So you can join the Illuminary. It will be like the same platform. It will be the big Zoom platform, and there are different under the IHMA national webinar. So thank you all, Dr. Anupriya.
Yeah. Thank you all. Thank you so much, participants. And we'll meet in season 3. So be healthy, be safe, stay tuned with us. Thank you so much.